Hi, I'm Stephanie from the class of 2021. Today we'll be doing our first virtual assembly. We'll go through some helpful tips, words of information, and videos from people in our school. Our first message comes from Dr. Conrad. Take it away.
As the head of school, I want you to know one very important thing. While these times will temporarily change what we do, they will not change who we are. We are still dedicated, we are still inspiring, we are still caring, and yes, we are still Chargers. As you watch this, CHH faculty, staff, administrators are all connecting, planning, innovating, sometimes goofing around. But we are certainly focused on one common goal, and that's turning this uncertain time into the most valuable opportunity possible for all CHCH students. There's much we don't know about the near future, but one thing we do know is that learning, support, and community will continue at CHCH. The first step is ensuring that all of our students can take this journey with us. To move forward as a school and community, we must move forward together. We've confirmed that everyone has the technology and access they need to connect, engage, and succeed. CHCH's strong foundation has been built on some core elements, and these will continue to drive us no matter where our community is located. Our teachers have always taught lessons that are experiential, collaborative, and inspirational. As we move online, their passion, expertise, and ingenuity will continue to create lessons that inspire and engage. I've seen some of the ideas our teachers are bringing to their curriculum, and I'm excited for the classes to begin. CHCH will also continue to be the place where students are given every opportunity to unlock their passions within. Our faculty have already come up with several ingenious community service opportunities that students can take part in at home. And we hope students will work to continue the phenomenal work generated through our student-led clubs. The relationships and trust between CHCH teachers and students have always been crucial, and they matter now more than ever. Students will continue to connect with their teachers in class and other times reserved for questions and support. Our school counselors, SAS teachers, college counselor, and other support service folks will continue to be available virtually for all our students. Finally, the CHCH community is known to be nothing if not caring and empathic. We will continue to support one another as we understand that this is new and challenging for everybody. We are in this together, Chargers. I am hopeful and also confident that we will emerge from this time stronger. And I really look forward to seeing you back on campus as soon as possibly allowed. Take care of yourselves.
And now for tips on maintaining health and wellness, here are Mrs. Weber and Mrs. McDinger.
Hi everyone, welcome to Virtual Assembly. This is Ms. Weber checking in, just saying hi, and hope everyone is adjusting the best they can through all of this that we're going through together. And my tip of the week for wellness is find something small that you can do for self-care, something that will bring you joy amidst this complete change in routine. So for me, perk of working from home is I get to actually make my own lunch, and today, that means I get pancakes. Find your joy and do it. Reach out if you need to, I'm here for you.
Woof!
Hi Chapel Hill, it's Corey at home. Following the wellness tip of the week and doing something that brings me joy, reading a book to my daughter, Brogan. We're going to read Teach Us Amelia Bedelia.
Hey, Ms. Rosen here with your SAS tip of the week. Let's talk about creating positive workspaces. There's four things that you should remember. The first is to find a dedicated workspace all your own. The second is to take away distractions, whether this is putting the desk in a corner or facing it away from things such as the television. The third is to make sure you have all of your materials with you before classes start, like chargers, pencils, textbooks. That way you don't have to keep getting up if you're forgetting something. And the fourth is to make it your own. Add some decorations, maybe some pictures. You'll be way more productive if you're enjoying the space that you're in.
And your technology tip of the week for Mr. Andrew Chow.
Hey everyone, it's Mr. Andrew Chow with your distance learning tech tip of the week. Be sure to check your audio before heading into class. Nobody notices when you have good audio, but everyone will notice when you have.
For the first in our Meet Your Pet series, Axel from the class of 2023 will be showing us his pet, but you may not be able to guess what it is before we show you.
I'm Axel, if you don't know, and I dyed my hair over break, and yeah, I'm gonna introduce you to my pet pig, Linus. Yeah. Liny. Okay. Yeah, his name is Linus, and he's, I think, 6 or 7. And yeah, he used to live with us inside of our house, but yeah, now he lives out in this barn. Okay, thank you.
As you can see, the streets are very busy today, but Aiden and Gabe will keep us well informed while we're home on quarantine.
Hello everyone, it is Aiden here with your regularly scheduled traffic announcement. We are in Canton, Massachusetts right now, driving down Dedham Street, which I've mentioned before as being a problem area due to planned works over the bridge. So for today, because we're doing this over video, I thought we'd do something a little special, and I'm going to take you down the road itself so you can see exactly where the problem areas are and how you can avoid them. So right now we're starting to approach the beginning of the roadworks. As you can see, there's some signs up already. And this is where it starts now. So beyond, right around here is where the road is actually going to be closed after 9 p.m. and that'll go until 5 a.m. There's ongoing works throughout the day sometimes. Sometimes traffic may be halted or be forced to shift over to the side of the road, which in itself can take up some extra time if you're driving down here.
Hey guys, it's Gabe here from the class of 21. I have a traffic report for you. There's no one here. There's no cars on Main Street. Have a good day.
As part of the Senior Legacy Project, the senior class is collecting inspirational messages to share with the community. Ben, from the class of 2020, has a special message to share with everyone.
Times of stress. The best thing we can do for each other is to listen with our ears and our hearts, and to be assured that our questions are just as important as our answers. Fred Rogers. Dear friends and classmates, I know things seem hard right now. They very much are. Rest assured, we will get through this. I'm not saying it will be easy, because it certainly will not be. But please cherish the memories you've had so far. You are all strong people, and I'm proud to be your classmate. Thank you very much.
Now the CHCH faculty and staff have recorded a few messages for the students who are getting started with distance learning this week.
Hi there, CHCH. This is Mrs. Walsh and Dozer checking in from a very quiet campus. We miss you all, but we're just chiming in to say you've got this and we'll see you online soon.
You got this!
Hi, students. My friend here and I just wanted to send you a quick message and let you know that you've got this. While this is certainly different, different doesn't have to mean bad and scary. There are so many of us here to help you, so please make sure you reach out and let us know what you need.
You got this.
You got this.
What is the message?
You don't got
this. No, that's not right. It's the opposite of that.
Hey everyone, Mr. Whitman here. Me and Gigi just wanted to let you know you've got this.
Coming to you live from my basement where I'm hiding from my children because I cut short their post-nap book so I could come talk to you about it. I was reading them, The Very Hungry Caterpillar, and I thought about you because, like The Very Hungry Caterpillar, we are all sort of eating our way through house and home and now stuck in cocoons. And while it might seem dark and dreary and there's no way out, there is a light at the end of the tunnel, and I believe in you, I'm thinking about you. We are all gonna break out of those cocoons and become glorious, beautiful butterflies and have the rest of our lives ahead of us. So stay healthy, stay happy, and stay safe.
Hi there, this is Mrs. Keating from my home studio/classroom. This is the space that I'll be working in teaching in this distance learning trimester. This is where I usually work to create my own artwork and my printmaking pieces that I do. You want a quick tour here? I have some references behind me that I use, some books, organized by color, of course. And then my studio mate, Wyatt. Can you say hi, honey?
Hi.
Wyatt's working on something on the iPad right now, creating his own artwork. We've been trying to make a piece of artwork every single day. I'm making an alphabet, a quarantine alphabet. My husband's making something every day too, so trying to keep our spirits high while we work in this space. So thanks for joining us and see you soon. Bye-bye.
Hi, students.
Hi, everybody. This is Leslie Jacobson Kay. I wanted to share something with you that I've been working on while I've been working from home. In addition to being a part of the advancement team, I am also an opera singer, so I've been working on something on the musical side. About 100 of us from 8 different countries came together, and we recorded separately, and then someone put it together into this really cool piece by Mozart, and it was a really fun project to work on, and I wanted to share it with you, and I really hope you enjoy it.
Want to hear a fun fact? All right, if you're like me, you haven't been doing a ton recently, but I've been catching up on my nature videos, and I want to introduce you to a new friend that I discovered. This little guy, which you should be able to see behind me, is called Costaciella coorshimae. And in other words, this is called the leaf sheep nudibranch. Fun fact about this little guy, only 5 millimeters long, feeds on algae. This is only one of the only sea creatures that is able to absorb the chloroplasts out of the algae that it eats. It steals them and incorporates it into its little tiny like tentacle things that I think you can see. Meaning that it is actually a solar-powered sea creature. This process is called kleptoplasty, which means it steals the chloroplasts and incorporates it into itself. And now you know.
Hi, today we're gonna make steak and cheese calzone. I cooked up already about 1.25 pounds of shaved steak with an onion and let it cool. It's best to use cool things. So whenever I do it, I make the filling ahead of time if it's something that has to cool until it gets to a nice, good, as bigger than a cookie sheet. I do it in a big rectangle. And then, yeah, top it with the steak. And again, a thin row across the middle. You take the part of the dough that's closest to you and you fold it over to the back. You take the sides, fold them in on top, sides, fold them in, and you take the top and wrap it over and under. And do that in the middle. You spray it with a little Pam. And then I shake the calzone on it, kind of like a horseshoe. Do it at about 375 for about 20 minutes, 25, until it's golden brown.
Let's celebrate birthdays with the Daniels family.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Mr. Velocca, Mr. Spencer, Emily, Jean, Nate, C. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you for watching, and thank you so much to the community members that sent in videos. Please have a great first week back.